Hello everyone, my name is Chitra Goswami and this video is for summary of lesson number 71 and the name of the lesson is Going to the Doctor. The objectives of this lesson are the students are able to understand vocabulary they might encounter when visiting a doctor and students will practice role-playing scenarios to stimulate doctor-patient interactions and improve their confidence. So, for the first step, you are going to share your experience of visiting a doctor. You can say that I went to a doctor when I had a stomach ache. As I sat in the waiting room, I noticed a funny sign that said, laughter is the best medicine, but if you laugh for no reason, you need medicine. It lightened the mood instantly. Now you will ask students if they have any experiences of visiting a doctor. For the second step, you are going to ask their students to read the notice in part A of their SRB and discuss the questions that follow with the whole class. You are going to extend student understanding by explaining which doctors. A witch doctor is considered to remove evil spirits with the help of magic. And then you will ask the students whether a patient would visit a clinic or hospital if they have cancer, mild diarrhea, a fracture or dengue. For the third step, you are going to ask the student to pair up and look at part B1 of their SAB for people and objects found at the clinic or hospital. You are going to conduct pronunciation drill for the words in part B1 of the SAB. You will ask the students to read the conversation given in part B2 and you are going to ensure that both the partners take turn to play the doctor and the patient. Now, for the fourth step, you're going to ask the student to prepare and present a role play with their partner. Each role play must include an opening greeting, conversation about illness, conversation using words that are learnt in the lesson illness, diagnosis and treatment, and a closing sentence. The next part of the lesson is revision, and for this, you can use this time to revise any previously covered topics that your students require more practice in. After the revision, you are going to ask the students to log in into their Duolingo account and you are going to let the students begin their Duolingo practice. In the last 5 minutes, you are going to ask the students what Duolingo activities did they do today. Now, next, you can share that you will write a sentence on the board and you want everyone to talk to their partners and discuss the meaning of the underlined words and then create a new sentence with that word. You will then take response from the class. The sentences are given in your FRP. And after this activity is done, you are going to acknowledge the students for all their hard work and you are going to conduct the pledge. Thank you so much.